Hello guys, welcome to Tutorial Technology, and this is Suprotim back with another video. And in this series we will continue about our last video where we finished, that is Python interview questions. Again today we will discuss few questions for the beginners who so without any further delay, let's get started. Okay, so we will continue from our last video, and this is our first question. So first question is, what are negative indices? Let's take an example for this. Suppose this is a list which we named as my list, and it contains value 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 0 to 8. A negative index, unlike a positive one, begins searching from the right. So my list minus 3 would give us 8 is minus 1, 7 is minus 2, 6 is minus 3, so it will give us 6. This also helps with slicing from the back. So for example, if we give slicing like this, my list minus 6 to minus 1, so this will give you 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, now our next question is, how would you randomize the content of a list in a place? For this we will import the function shuffle from the module random. From random import shuffle, this is the denotation which we use, then shuffle my list. If you print then my list, then it will automatically shuffle it like this. So our next question is, explain join and split in Python. Join let us character from a string together by a character we specify. So if we type join 1 2 3 4 5, it will print like this 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. If we type split, let us split a string around the character we specify. So if it is say we want to split by comma, then we need to mention this is the number string which we have 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. If we use dot split by comma, then it will give at in return it will give us a list which will contain 1 2 3 4 5 individually. Now what is the differentiate between list and tuples? The major differentiate is that a list is mutable and a tuple is immutable. So our next question is Python case sensitive? Yes, the answer is yes. So you can say a language is case sensitive if it is distinguished between identifiers like my name and my caps my name. In other words, it cares about case lowercase or uppercase. Okay, let's try with an example. So if you type a variable my name is equal to Ayushi, and while printing if you type m in caps my name, it will throw us an error. Name error, my name is not defined. So as you can see, it raised a name error. That means the Python is indeed case sensitive. Okay, So let's move to next question. How do you remove the leading white space in a string? So this is an important one, and you will face it in daily basis. So leading white space in a string is the white space in a string before the first non-white space character. To remove it from a string, we use the method isstrip. As for example, in this example, if you see the string Ayushi, it has a white space in front of A. So you type Ayushi dot lstrip, then it will print Ayushi. Again, if you want to string the right hand side, so you type rsstrip, so it will remove the white space from after I. So our next question is, how would you convert a string into lowercase? Well, this is also an interesting one. We use the lower method for this. Say suppose your name contain caps in between, or starting from, if you put lower, Ayushi dot lower, it will, the whole string will becomes lower. To convert into the uppercase, use upper. Also, to check if a string is all uppercase or all lowercase, we use the method is upper is lower. It returns true or false. As for you see, Ayushi is upper, false. Ayushi is upper, true. Ayushi lower, true. Ayushi is lower, true. Ayushi is upper, true. So as you can see, this @ character and dollar character in between. So character like @ and dollar will suffice for both the cases. Also, isTitle method will tell us the string is in title case. The corpse bright is title will return true because the T, C and B are in caps. So let's move to our next question. What is the pass statement in Python? There may be times in our code when we haven't decided what to do yet, but we must type something for it to be statistically correct. In such case, we use the pass statement. So let's take this function, and you should know the functions are defined as def define. So define function, and you have given arguments as star args and pass. Similarly, the break statement breaks out of a loop. So suppose for I in range of 7, if I is equal to 3, print break print I. So it will hit 1, 2 and it will break. So finally the state continue statement skips to the next iteration. For I range in 7, if I is equal to 3, continue. Print I. So it will print 1, 2, then it will, if 3 is continue, then we will skip again, then 4, 5, 6. So let's move to our next question, and this is, what is a closure in Python? A closure is said to occur when a nested function references a value in its enclosing scope. The whole point here is that it remembers the value. So, let us define a function a and pass a value x, and again define another function b and pass it nothing here. So the whole point is to return, if we then print x, return b. So it will, if we pass the value a 7 and comma, then we will return 7. So that's it, guys. Hope you like it, and we will back with more interview question and answer for you. Till then, bye bye. Thank you.